while you became companions of them that were used. In other words, you're going to be abused. Some of y'all are going to be thrown in jail. He says, but you take the faith that we're partners now. There was a time at the Church of Christ when I was growing up. We were knocking on doors. Folks would laugh at us. You know, Church of Christ folks, they did this, that, and that. We didn't care. You know, as a matter of fact, we appreciate when they talk about us. That was old school Church of Christ. This is new school. Ooh, it's too high to go to the door doctor. Ooh, I got air conditioning in the car, but I got to have it. We think of everything. We want everything to be comfortable now. Bible study, ooh, I got to get a nail appointment. I can't do that. That's going to mess up my day. I can't say, ooh. Everything is about convenience now. We put on the back burner the will of God and the front burner the will of Caesar, the will of Michael. That's more important. He says, you had to endure, verse 34, for you have compassion of me in my bonds, and you took joyfully the spoiling of your goods. In other words, these people, this is a historical fact, when these Hebrew Christians were persecuted, their families even rejected. There were Christians during this time that, because they once were Jewish and believed in the Jewish faith, and when they rejected it with Jesus, people made fun of them. Not only that, people would go into their house. You heard of home invasions, now people kick in the front door now. People would have home invasions and steal everything they had. He says, and you were joyful when they did that. I don't know about you, but the little stuff I got in my house, I don't want nobody to take it. But as a child of God, because their outlook was upward instead of forward, they could even accept the fact that somebody was still in this world. They said, you know why? Because the stuff we got is temporary anyway. God bless you. Stuff you stole from me, be replaced. They said today, a few months ago, there was a young man who moved in with his girlfriend, not dealing with the morality of it. But he moved to the city, moved to an apartment. He wasn't sure about the layout of the apartment. Came home one night after they'd been out. Dad's key went to a certain door, put the key in, heard somebody on the other side. Who was that? Looked at his home, it was the wrong apartment. Man came out with a gun. Opened the door and said, he said, sir, I'm sorry, I got the wrong apartment. He said, oh, you got the right. He said, I'm in the wrong place. He started backing up, running away from the man. Man ran after him, shot him 6 times and killed him. Because we love possessions more than we love people.
Yeah.
He says, verse 34, and he's saying, well, you had compassion with my bonds and took joyfully the spoiling of your goods, knowing in yourselves that you have heaven. Then an endurance substance, cast not away, therefore, your confidence, which have great recompense of reward, for you have need of patience. That's that same Greek word, upomone, that after you have done the will of God, you might receive the promise. And yet a little while, he that shall come will come and will not tarry, he will not loiter. Now, the just, the just will live by faith. He says, but if any man draw back, if any man shrinks back, that's what the word means. If any man says, I once was a Christian, but now I don't want to be a Christian anymore. He says, my soul has no pleasure in him. He says that if you do that, he says, but we are not of them who draw back unto perdition, but of them that believe to the saving of the soul. Brothers and sisters, this is an encouraging message this morning. I hope and pray that somebody here who's thinking about giving up, somebody here who's on the verge of saying, I'm through with Christianity, I can't take it anymore. I'm tired of people in the church. I'm tired of folks lying. I'm tired of folks talking about me. Let me tell you, you got something better than these people on earth. I say all the time, and no man, well, let me say, I'm gonna get man, not none, man, one of y'all wants to meet him. Because I know who I serve. And if you want to cut up and miss out on heaven, you go right ahead. But I'm going there. And I don't care who thinks this, who says that, because my focus is not on you. Now, I'll try to help you along the way, but I'm not going to get caught up in your foolishness.
Right.
Because the devil can use you just like he can use me. And his goal is to send you to hell just like it's to send me to hell. And that's why we have to do these things. We have to be careful. We can't forsake the sin. We have to incite one another to love. We have to do all these things because the time is short. And for that reason, there's somebody who might be here this morning that says, I want to be in the body, Brother Clark, because I heard you talk about the one body. And when Jesus comes, he's only coming back for that one body. I'm glad you asked that question. The Bible still says there's one Lord, one faith, one baptism. He said that before there was any denomination. And he still say that today. All who are going to be saved are going to be saved in that one body.
Amen.
The way you get into that one body is to obey the gospel plan. The Bible says he, indiscriminate, that believeth and is baptized shall be saved. He that believeth not shall be damned. Mark chapter 16, verses 15 and 16. The first thing that goes open in the church, Acts chapter 2, verse 37, they said, men and brethren, what shall we do? Peter stood up and said, repent, be baptized, every one of you, for the remission of your sin, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. Brothers and sisters, God has grace and is offering today. The question is, do you want it saved? Do you want to come through the doors of the ark this morning? You can't, right now, as we stand and say,
blessed assurance.